Smiling. As he pushed at me, the best beloved before him, tender even in severity, the jealous one, so that I push this blissful hour before me. Away with thee, thou blissful hour, with thee hath there come to me an involuntary bliss. Ready for my severest pain do I here stand, at the wrong time hast thou come. Away with thee, thou blissful hour, rather harbor there with my children, hasten, and bless them before eventide with my happiness. There, already after death eventide, the sun sinketh. Away my happiness. Thus spake Zarathustra, and he waited for his misfortune the whole night, but he waited in vain. The night remained clear and calm, and happiness itself came nigher and nigher unto him. Towards morning, however, Zarathustra laughed in his heart, and said mockingly, and what? Happiness runneth after me. That is because I do not run after women. Happiness, however, is a woman, and what? Before sunrise. 48. Before sunrise. L.A. now. O heaven above me, thou pure, thou deep heaven, thou abyss of light, gazing on me, I tremble with divine desire. Up to thy height to toss myself that is my death, in thy purity to hide myself that is mine innocence. The god veils his beauty, thus hidest thou thy stars. Thou speakest not, thus proclaimest thou thy wisdom unto me. Mute o'er the raging sea hast thou risen for me today, thy love and thy modesty make a revelation unto my raging soul. In that thou earnest unto me beautiful, veiled in thy beauty, in that thou spackest unto me mutely, obvious in thy wisdom, oh, how could I fail to divine all the modesty of thy soul? Before the sun didst thou come unto me the lonesomest one. We have been friends from the beginning, to us are grief, gruesomeness, and ground common, but even the sun is common. Much. We do not speak to each other, because we know too. We keep silent to each other, we smile our knowledge to each other. Art thou not the light of my fire? Hast thou not the sister soul of mine insight? Together did we learn everything. Together did we learn to ascend beyond ourselves to ourselves, and to smile unclouded. Edly, unclouddedly the smile down out of luminous eyes and out of miles of distance, when under us restrained in purpose and goat stream like rain. And wandered I alone, for what did my soul hunger by night and in labyrinth and paths? And climbed I mountains, who did I ever see, if not thee, upon mountains? T82. Thus spake Zarathustra. And all my wandering and mountain climbing, a necessity was it merely, and a makeshift of the unhandy one, to fly only, wanteth mine entire will, to fly into thee. And what have I hated more than passing clouds, and whatever coin death be? In mine own hatred have I even hated, because it came to thee. The passing clouds I detest, those stealthy cats of prey. They take from me and me what is common to us, the vast unbounded yea and amen saying. These mediators and mixers we detest, the passing clouds. Those half and half ones, that have neither learned to bless nor to curse from the heart. Rather will I sit in a tub under a closed heaven, rather will I sit in the abyss without heaven, then see thee, thou luminous heaven, tainted with passing clouds. And oft have I longed to pin them fast with the jagged gold wires of lightning, that I might, like the thunder, beat the drum upon their kettle bellies, an angry drummer, because they rob me of thy yea and amen. Thou heaven above me, thou pure, thou luminous heaven, thou abyss of light, because they rob thee of my